back to the session of our online classes. Today we have to start from page 8, right? Such unhealthy situations can occur in democratic societies too, where a majority can continuously enforce decisions that exclude minorities and go against their interest. As the above storyboard illustrates, every society is born to this trainee of the majority. Children, this word trainee means where the people are misusing their powers and authority with in a injustice manner or with in a cruel behavior. The constitution usually contains rules that ensure that minorities are not excluded from anything that is routinely available to the majority. Another reason why we have a constitution is precisely to prevent this tyranny or domination by the majority to the minority, right? Another reason why the people of a country need a constitution is it's to stop that domination, that discrimination, you can say, or this tyranny that I told you, the cruel and injustice use of someone's power and authority. To stop all this by the majority people on the minority people, constitution is very important for the country. This can refer to one community dominating another, that is inter-community domination, or members of one community dominating the other within the same community, that is intra-community domination. Yes, children, it is not necessary that it can be the different communities, like one community is on a higher level and the other community is on the smaller. The domination is not done in this only, but also in a particular same community. The person who is having a high power can dominate a person who is at a low level of the same community, right? The third significant reason why we need constitution is to save us from ourselves. It may sound strange, but what it is meant by this is that we might at times feel strongly about an issue that might go against our large interest, and the constitution helps us to guard against it. Look at the storyboard below to understand this better. Right now, the third significant reason here is given is to protect ourselves from us only. Right, there are many cases where the decisions made by the government, you are feeling that it is not correct for yourself. So constitution helps us to come out from this also. Similarly, the constitution helps to protect us against certain decisions that we might take that could have an adverse effect on the large principles that the country believes in. For example, it is possible that many people who live in democracy might come to strongly feel that party politics has become a acrimonious, that we need a strong dictator to set this right. Yes, dictator. We need a speaker or a leader who can direct our views to the higher authorities. Swept by this emotion, they may not only realize that in a long run, dictatorial rule goes against all their interest. The good constitution does not allow these whims to change its basic structure. It does not allow for the easy overthrow of provisions that guarantees rights of citizens and protect their freedom. Right, like that means the rules, or you can say the rights that are made for the citizens of a particular country. Constitution helps to protect those rights, and it is not easy to just go through and don't listen or don't obey such rules or regulation that has been made in the constitution. It can be punishable also. From the above discussion, you will understand that constitution plays a very important role in a democratic society. Now, let us try and understand the ways in which above points get translated into certain ideals and rules, studying some key features of the Indian Constitution. Right now, we will study about the few key features of the Indian Constitution. But By the beginning of the 20th century, the Indian National Movement that have been active in the struggle for independence from British rule for several decades, right? When this Indian National Movement started? When people of the country began to go against the Britishers, came together and fought for their struggle. That was known as Indian National Movement. During the freedom struggle, the nationalists had devoted a great deal of time to imagining and planning about a free India. Yes, because the struggle was not only for a year, it was decades. And the freedom fighters have imagined every time of having a free country. Under the British, they had been forced to obey rules that they had very little role in making. Yes, in Britishers' rules were being forcibly had to be forcibly followed by the people, whether it is good for them or bad for them. The long experience of authoritarian rule under the colonial state convinced Indians that free India should be a democracy in which everyone should be treated equally and be allowed to participate in government. Yes, because during the when the Britishers' rule was going on, Indians were not having any rights. Their suggestions, their ideas were not being considered by the Britishers. Even they were discriminated at every point, every step, right? There was a racial discrimination in a very large amount, and they were not treated equally. So when the struggle of Indian freedom was going on, the freedom fighters who were fighting for the struggle thought that when we will get our India free, it will be a democratic country. Why? Because democratic country is a place where every people have got different rights and everyone has got right to say or practice any of his religion, or you can say any of his practices. When remained to be done then was to work out the ways in which a democratic government would be set up in India and the rules that would determine its functioning. Right, so when the freedom was being started, then the government, a democratic government was to be formed, and some rules should be formed by the government that should be functioned. This was done not only by one person but a group of around 300 people who became members of the constitution. Right now, when we start something, it is not made by a particular one person. There are several amount of person, there are several amount numbers of people who are combining together and forming all this. So that time the members of the constitution assembly were 300 in an year was in 1946, and who met periodically for the next 3 years to write Indian constitution. Right, students, today I'm ending till here. Again tomorrow I will be coming back with same topic for more key features.